So starting March 12th, the Census Bureau will mail you a postcard and it will give you instructions on how to respond to the census online. So online, you enter a code, and really the census only asks you your name, your address, if you own or rent your home, how many people live with you, and then the ages, sex, and race of each person in the household. That's it. And so if you're concerned about online answering, they've put protections in place, but you can also still answer by phone, or you can answer with a paper survey that'll come later if you don't respond with the first three reminders that they send you. And then if at that point you still haven't responded, census teams will be out in your neighborhood and they'll be going door to door to houses that they know haven't responded. They don't know you personally, and so you're protected in that way. So you don't need to be nervous about giving your information. Some people believe that there are agencies that can get your information so that you fill out the census and ICE will have your information, or the FBI or the police. And actually it's written into law that no agency can have your information from the Census Bureau. The goal of the census in 2020 is to count every person. So in the Constitution, it's mandated that there's a census every 10 years, and the reason is that so we know how many people live in the United States, and that determines the money, but also your state representatives, so how many a state gets. And, you know, that is very critical for us. So if you want representation, you need to be counted. The most underrepresented population in the last census count was children ages 0 to 4. Children ages 0 to 4 are affected by Head Start funding, they're affected by school funding, they're affected by Title I funding in your community. And so we want to make sure that they're counted, and a lot of families think about people in their household as adults, but really the census needs to know every person in your house. And so if you're a grandparent with children in your house that live with you, count the children. If you are a foster parent, or if you are watching somebody's child for them while they're overseas, if they're incarcerated, you need to count that child. Here at the Patterson Foundation, we did a little trial run, and we found that on average, it takes a person 2 minutes per person in their household to respond to the census. So for my husband and myself, it took me 4 minutes to answer the census. So the Patterson Foundation works to strengthen individuals, organizations, and the community. And through our Census 2020 education project, we believe that communities and individuals have a rare privilege to affect our community for the next 10 years.